everyone. Welcome back to the channel. It's Lauren. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're doing well. Today, I wanted to actually go through my holiday 2022 makeup purchases. I'm going to be using a lot of them to get ready today, and then I thought, like, toward the end, I would just, like, let you guys know my thoughts on some of this stuff. I did a video earlier this Vlogmas and talked about some past holiday makeup releases that I have in my collection and what I thought about them basically, like, a year, if not more, later, because depending on what year they came out. And I thought I could try to be introspective about what I've purchased so far this year and just, you know, discuss it. I also kind of wanted to just get them all together. Like, what did I buy from holiday collections this year? Because there I felt like was a lot of tempting stuff, and I tried my best this year to really be aware of, like, how long I'm gonna like something, how long I'm gonna wanna use it, and tried, as I feel like I always try to do, to add stuff that I really felt connected to, that I really felt like I was gonna like long term. And so, yeah, we're gonna do that. I'm just putting on some primer. I use the Stila one. I'm gonna use this Hydromaniac from Tarte. Urban Decay. I'm gonna put it on with a sponge today. I don't have like a full face of the holiday makeup because I really focus mostly on like color products, I would say, overall. And like, can you imagine if they came out with a foundation for holiday? Like the holiday limited edition foundation release. Like, honestly, I wouldn't put it past these brands at some point, but we haven't gotten there yet, thank goodness. So a lot of the stuff that I have that is from holiday is more color cosmetics, and I do have some duplicates like for eyeshadows and things like that. So I can't put it all on my face, but I thought it'd be fun to do another kind of like get ready with me with it and use it as often as I can during the season while you guys might have picked some of that stuff up as well. I've been trying to use this foundation more and just, you know, enjoy it. And I do really like it with a brush. It's looking really good over this primer too, which is great. I like it. What am I saying? I am losing my mind, I feel like. Vlogmas already. I know we're only on day, I think it's day 10 today. Oh baby, it's a lot. It's been really fun, and I hope you guys have been enjoying the videos too, but damn, I'm tired. I'm tired already. I feel like though, hopefully I'm getting past this kind of, you know, when you're working hard and you're like, you get your second wind, I guess. I feel like I'm on the verge of getting my second wind. So that's good. I need it. I freaking need it. But I hope you guys' holidays have been going well so far. I feel like I'm already to that point where I'm like, okay, like I'm ready for the days to be long again. Summer nights, like, oh yeah. Oh yeah, I'm excited. I mean, not actual the heat, but just the sunlight. I miss the sunlight. That's what I miss, guys. I'm using the Glossier Stretch Concealer. I know this stuff isn't holiday. I hope you guys don't mind. But I feel like in the video where I was doing Sephora stuff, like a Sephora try-on, and also like the review after, a lot of people like me actually talking while trying stuff instead of only just reviewing. So I hope you'll like this video. I hope you like it. It's been so nice, I have to say. This is turning into a chatty get ready with me, but it's just been nice to really enjoy filming and enjoy makeup and just all of it, you know? Such a treat, because there are just different phases in life, and it feels so good to be back in this phase for sure. I'm using the Hourglass powder. When I did my declutter, I was like, I'm gonna pull that. I'm gonna try to use it. So that's what we're doing today. I'm gonna use this brush from Oden's Eye and do just like the tiniest bit of sculpting, bronzing, that type of thing really fast. Maybe a lot. I'm going for, I think, a bit of a kind of cool toned, almost like berry pink kind of look today. Not on my eyes, but like for the lips and even the cheeks a little bit. And then I'm hoping to do, okay, this is looking red. This is a denser brush than I've been using. It might not be the right one. This might be a little too heavy of application for this color, but hopefully it'll all come together. I'm gonna beat some of it back. I'm gonna use a cream and a powder blush today. So I'm gonna use this Wander Beauty Stick cream. So this, I guess this is kind of like a combo, honestly, of using things I kind of discovered in my declutter, but also holiday stuff. So I'm just using that with a brush. It's a little bit pinker than I thought it was gonna go on. It kind of smells gross. Why does my brush? My brush kind of smells gross. Fucking, that's disgusting. Have you guys ever had a brush smell like, I don't know, almost like latex? What the heck? All right, moving past that, let's add some powder. I'm just using the Kosas one. I just don't want to be too glowy. All right, now that we have a cream down, all that, we're going to go in with the first actual holiday product I know. And is there a hair? Okay. This is the Charlotte Tilbury face palette. This is the only like face palette I bought this year, even though so many came out. I was so tempted by every last single freaking one of them, okay? And I'm so glad I just bought this one. So far, I've really been enjoying it. I'm a little bit sad that it's probably not gonna be available, you know, super long term. I just hate that. But I do think it's really pretty, and it's one of those products that I can see myself using not just through winter time or through the holidays. The colors I feel like will suit me a long time. I really like the formula on the products in here, even though I will say the blushes need a stiff brush. That's the only thing. You really got to pick it up with like a natural hairbrush. So if you don't like that, you might not like this, but I feel like it's pretty nice. I love the highlighters in here as well. I'll use this pink highlighter in here to put on my nose. But I like the highlighters in here overall. Okay, I'll do a little on the cheeks too. I think it's a nice formula, like nice and shiny, and I am excited for her highlighters that are coming out though. So this I am really happy with. It's just so expensive. That's like the one thing. Buying this palette made me realize like, damn, prices. I think this is like either $75 or like $85. And that is very pricey. When I think of it that way, I'm like, woo. But I do like it overall still. I'm still happy with that as my choice, I think, for a face palette this year. And I think I would be happiest with it out of all the other ones, like the NARS one that came out, the Patrick Ta one that came out, even the Pat McGrath ones that came out. I'm trying to think what else. Tarte had one that was kind of tempting me. I am happy with this one out of all of those. I did pick up another highlighter though, so I'll talk about that here. This is the Pat McGrath Venusian Nude Highlighter, and this is really beautiful. Like, again, I'm really happy I picked this one up too. I probably could have waited to get it on sale, but I was just like, I have to know what this is because I love the one from last year so much. So there's a swatch of it. It has like a rosy kind of peachy undertone. I'm actually gonna use a little bit of it right here because this has like a bit of a sparkle to it, which I quite like. I like a sparkly highlighter. And so although this is very similar to the color, like I really don't think if you have last year's, you need this year's, or if you have this year's, like I don't think you're necessarily missing out. Although I think by the tiniest hair, last year's beats out this one, but this one does have a little bit more sparkle going on to it, but nothing that's like glitter, like nothing actually glittery. So I am happy with this. This is another very expensive piece, but it's just one of those kind of like show-stopping pieces to me. I love the imprint, I love the embossing, all that. So I am happy to have it. I know that I would have always been like wanting to know what it was like, you know? So I'm still happy with that one, but probably could have got it on sale just because it's so similar to last year's. I wish I knew that, but you know, you don't know until you swatch them next to each other. I think it's time for me to do some eyebrows. So I'm gonna do that really fast. I'm just gonna use my Persona. I'm gonna use a little bit of this Rowan brow pencil, which is almost done, like literally on its last legs. I'm getting one more makeup empty in before the end of the year. Okay, brows are looking pretty good. I'm gonna prime and use a shadow stick. I don't normally do both, but I'm gonna try that today. So I'm just using a little bit of the Urban Decay, and the shadow stick I'm using is from Moira. I'm using the shade in Cashmere Rose. This is a cream color, so it's like a matte look and has no shimmer to it, but I thought this would be a good base because I am gonna go just a tiny bit smokier all over, I feel like, and this I think will just give me a little bit more of that depth pretty naturally, like starting off with it. Still not dark, don't get me wrong, but for some reason, I feel like this step, a lot of the time when I'm doing something, even like mid-tone, just helps like everything come together in a different way. It feels like a nothing step, but I don't know, man, it changes it. Okay, now for eyeshadows, what to use, that's the question, because I have a lot of different eyeshadows here. Some of the stuff that you probably have seen that I picked up for holiday, which I should zoom out just a little while I talk about these so you can really see them. I picked up both of the five pans from Pat McGrath, which she is launching some new ones. I'm not gonna pick those ones up, but I'm excited that five pans seem to be a direction we're going. Anyway though, this one is the Nude Allure. So beautiful, so happy with that. This is the Bronze Bliss, another one one so, so happy with. These are two that I really do love. Like, I just love the size of them. I love that they're neutral. I feel like these shimmers that are in here are so stunning and beautiful and just absolutely amazing. And there's only one matte in each of these, which is perfect for me. Like, that's what I want. I want one matte and then a bunch of shimmers overall. I mean, mattes are great, but shimmers are what get me excited. And I also just like love doing shimmery looks. So these really just felt so perfect. I love that they're small, just really, really good pickups for me. So I might do something with that. I haven't decided. I recently, like as in yesterday, the video that went up yesterday, this is the KVD Moon Garden palette. This was a last minute pickup because I just felt like no one was talking about it and I just freaking had to know what was going on. So if you want a more in-depth video, check that out. I still feel kind of on the edge about this. It's not that I like regret picking it up because again, it's kind of like the Pat McGrath, like I just had to know. I just had to know. But I love this color story so much, but I'm just unsure about some of the more satiny finishes in here. I was reading through the comments and a lot of you guys were saying you love a satin finish and you're excited for that. And I do too. I do like a satin finish. I was just hoping with these colors, there would be something a little bit extra and special, you know? Whereas if it was a bunch of like satin neutral shades, I'd kick it down with that finish like even better. But I'm kind of on the fence about this one. Glad I picked it up. So many of you guys didn't even know this launched. So I guess that's the reason no one's talking about it because no one knows it even exists, honestly. Some other holiday palettes. These I got in PR, but I would have bought these like immediately. I would have made sure, I would have set an alarm for these babies. And unfortunately, they're not coming back. They're already sold out. They did a pre-order and then that sold out. So I hate to rub it in if you didn't get these, but I do. I love these so much. For a holiday themed palette, it's not only a holiday release, but it's also holiday themed. I just love this. So this is the Merry Christmas palette from Oden's Eye. I love this. I have a short doing a little look with this, so check that out. I also did a look each in the initial video I did with this if you want some more. I'm hoping I'll do another look with this palette too. At some point, we'll see. But this is the Christmas Eve palette. So the other one was Merry Christmas. This one's Christmas Eve, and they're just stunning. They have beautiful deep mattes. They have great shimmery textural shades. There's some duochromes, like just everything I want. And I feel like for color, like these two palettes, the color stories I just think are stunning. I especially love the Merry Christmas. And this one with its colorful color story are getting me. I'm like, okay, maybe I'm getting back into color a little bit. We have a few more palettes to go through, I know. Kind of last minute, I picked up the three quads that came out from Viseart. I picked these up during Black Friday and I think I might be like a huge Viseart stan now. It took me a long time to try the brand, but you guys, like I am so into I'm so into their quads specifically and especially, but I'm just like in the right place of mind to love these shadows than I was a couple years ago because I like the neutrals. So let me show you what these look like. This is the Lila's Dew palette and it's stunning. It's like a cool tone mauve-y purpley kind of color. I kind of want to just use that. Maybe I will use that. Oh no, I'm not set in stone for any reason. This one's probably the most stunning to me, the Violetta. Oh. This is just like a beautiful duochrome. Like I can't, I love it so much. And I really like these shadows because they're just a little more like wearable. They don't even have the most sparkly textures necessarily, but I just find them just easy to work with. They have satins, they have mattes, they have metallics, they have some sparkly shades. This one is the, I believe, Amelie palette. And that one's a little bit more neutral and warm toned, but I picked up all of those. I picked up a lot of Vizio. I need to do the Black Friday haul, but I just can't yet. I don't know why I haven't yet. I think everything is in. I should do that. I'm so sorry, guys. So I have those that I might want to work with, but then last for eyeshadows, really, I have some singles that I bought from Charlotte Tilbury. These are great. I'm really happy I picked them up, but I will say I was very tempted to pick up the entire line. You guys know, you saw that video. I was like, I'm going to get all, I'm about to order them all. And I will say, I'm happy that I kind of didn't do that. Not that I don't think they would be pretty because I think they would be stunning, but I'm really happy with the three that I have right now. And when I think of the other colors, although they're beautiful too, and maybe I would love them a ton, I just feel really content with these three. And these aren't cheap. These are not cheap. These are $34 a piece for a single freaking eyeshadow. And as much as I love the packaging, I think it is stunning. I'm happy with the three, you know? I got a little piece of the collection. I got a little bit of my heart in it. I love it, but we don't need all of them. And so this one's rose gold. So pretty. Probably my perfect one for every day, really. Cosmic Rocks. Really glad I picked this one up. It's a nice, like, duochrome, multichrome almost. And it has like a gray base, a blue, purple, teal kind of shift going on. Really, really stunning. I think a very special one. And then this one I really wanted, and this is Smoky Quartz, which is a beautiful, cool tone shimmer. Oh, so stunning. It's this one here. I know I got a lot going on, but it's that shade and it is so, so pretty. So I'm very happy, honestly, with almost all of the eyeshadows. The only one I could see myself kind of like, at the end of the day, maybe not picking up is the KVD palette. But even that, I'm still hopeful and I'm still gonna keep testing out. I still get inspired by the color story. So, and it's not like the shadows are shit. Like, to be clear, they're not shitty. I was really hopeful that it would be like, stunning, amazing, like the powder versions of the stick cream eyeshadows, you know? Maybe I was just putting like too much on it, you know? So now that we've run through all of that, my gosh, I know that's kind of a lot, but honestly, I'm really happy it's just that. There were some really great palettes. I was interested in the Pat McGrath Celestial Nirvana. Is that what it was this year? I think that was the name of it, but the holiday palette from Pat McGrath, like the bigger one, really tempted me. The Huda Empowered palette was kind of tempting me, and I'm glad ultimately I passed on it. Even some of the Tarte holiday releases. They had like this double palette I was kind of tempted by. Lots of ColourPop stuff like kind of was tempting. The Muppets palette I think looks so pretty. But so far I'm really happy with what I have, and I think that these will hopefully be used longer term in my collection. So let's actually create something, right? Like let's actually do something. So many options. I don't know what I want to do. I think I'm going to go in with a little bit of some mattes, and I'm going to go into the Lila's Do palette. I'm going to take this matte mauve kind of shade. I feel like that's kind of the vibe I want, and then I can always pick a specific, I don't know, single shadow or some other shadow from one of the palettes. So I'm just going to be putting that in my crease, but also kind of on the lid. Like I'm really getting something a little bit more smoky going on. I hope that cream shadow isn't going to fuck up my eyeshadow look, because I'll zoom you in. It is kind of tacky, and I don't want the shadow to like stick more to places where it stopped and then not stick where it didn't. You know what I mean? Anyway, that color is so pretty though. I love just how easy the Viseart shadows are to work with. I think that's what's so nice. They just blend out so beautifully. They're pigmented without being overly pigmented in a way that is hard to control. Like I can just keep building them up, and they kind of remind me of the NARS formula in that way, to me anyway. That's what I think is the most similar maybe that I know of. It's not like Natasha Denona or Pat McGrath, which I do like those formulas as well. Like they definitely have a place, but I feel like this is just still luxurious while being maybe a little more user-friendly. I think I'm gonna use the Smoky Quartz because I don't know why. I'm not sure if I've done a look with that on camera and I kind of want to. So I'm gonna put that on, I think, but I really wanna use this kind of in the outer corner, this like kind of navy. Do something a little different. Okay. I think I'm just gonna put this on with my finger. Just kind of rub it on top of the base we've laid down. Oh yeah. This one has a lot of sparkle to it. Like this really is a pop shot of sparkle. I don't feel like there's as much individual sparkle in the rose gold shadow as this one has, which makes it really fun. Like very, very fun. And makes it more special, but just thought I would note. Oh yeah, I love that. Okay, I'm gonna take a little brush and just kind of blend out the edges, make sure everything's looking nice. And then I think I'm gonna take, actually, I was gonna take that same brush, but I think I'm gonna try to find something a little bit denser. And I'm gonna go in with that kind of, it's like a navy gray. It's a little bit neutral, but I'm gonna be putting that, tapping off the extra, hoping for no fallout. I'm gonna just tap that palette in the outer corner. Oh yeah. I feel like I can tell in person at least, it's definitely looking a little bit navy, which I wanted. So I'm very happy with that. And there's something about, I'm telling you, a shimmery dark color that you're adding in the outer corner or something for depth that is just so sultry and sexy in a different way than a matte does it. Like it's just different. It really does hit different. I'm going back in and just kind of blending the edges. And then you know what? Now that I'm just here creating, I think that I'm gonna take some of this shimmery shade, this like a, that violet kind of purple flaky thing. And I'm gonna tap it in the center, in between those two colors. Ooh yeah, it's slight, but I love it. Okay. So into that. Definitely wanted, I just wanted something a little bit smokier today. I had a little bit of fallout, not too bad, but I'm taking the brush I used with my concealer and just kind of barely blending that out a little. I want to do something like shimmery on my brow bone. I think this might be too warm for everything going on. So I think I'm going to use the pink that's in here and I'm going to try to go lighter on my brow bone, really blend it out. I brought all the colors up pretty high and then I'm going to put it on my inner corner too. For a liner, I did pick up some liners for holiday. I got the KVD one that came out with the palette. I think there might have been another one as well, but this is a shade Bronzite Gold. I'm not gonna use that one today just for color because I have a better matching color, but I also did pick up this trio from Tarte and I've really been loving this. So one side is like a cream shadow and the other side is a liner. And I just think the formulas are nice. The colors are great. This was a really good pickup and I can see myself again using these very long term. I think these might be available all individually and like permanently, which I also really love. So I'm just going to use the shadow stick first on my bottom lash line. This has like kind of a purpley tinge going on. Same kind of like taupey, mauvey, purpley thing. I'm gonna blend out with my finger. But then I am gonna use the other side of this, and that is a black, and I'm gonna use that to tight line. And I'm gonna add a little tiny bit to my outer corner. I'm actually gonna go a little on the waterline. I don't normally do that, but just in that outer part, these are so creamy of liner. So if you really want a creamy liner, these are them. And then I'm gonna blend that out. All right, let's do some mascara. We're getting sultry. Okay, I think that's the eye look. I think I'm gonna add a little bit more concealer. The last time I used this brush to like clean up, I wasn't adding any new concealer, but I really wanna just make sure everything looks nice and clean since we have such a dark eye look. And then I'm gonna add a little bit more blush so I don't lose color. Who knew we were going for such a full glam moment? All right, I love it. I really actually love it. Even the black on that lower waterline just in the outer corner, it's a little bit much for me, but I still love it with everything else especially going on. And then for my lip, I don't know if this is gonna be too much, but I was planning on doing like the Glossier water tint with a little bit of like a pinkish liner. So we'll see. I'm gonna put that on. This one's from NYX. It's the shade Con, I think, like as in the French city. Don't mind my crusty little foundation lips. And then the Glossier water tint that I'm using is called Rose Splash. Hopefully it looks good. I don't know if this is this the moment it becomes tacky. I think so. Okay, I think I'm gonna do a matte lip, like a Dose of Colors liquid lipstick. Really go full glam. It already stained, it does its job really well, stains so fast. All right, I'm gonna use my normal lip liner from Makeup Forever, but then I'm gonna try the shade Mondays. Let's see how that looks. I think it's gonna look way better. Well, I guess I did kind of want to go a little bit darker and vampy, and I guess my dreams came true. So let me show you the eye look up close. This is it, all smoked out. I could have definitely done like a wing or something dark on top as well. I know we have like the dark shadow, but that bottom lash line is pretty smoky, so I think it could have handled it, but I still really like it. I like the lip too. Let's zoom out, see what it looks like together, because I haven't even seen that yet. Ooh, okay. I think it turned out. I actually kind of like both together. I feel like sometimes it's a little bit much to do both of those at the same time, like a darker lip, but because this is more neutral, it doesn't go too pink, it doesn't go too red, I feel like it still complements the eye look, but I guess you'll have to let me know what you guys think. I also love that it's matte too. I think the gloss would just distract as well. So I like it. Surprisingly, actually. I was getting nervous for a second. But anyway, I think that's all the holiday makeup. Some of my thoughts as I've been using it throughout this holiday season. I'm really happy with the pieces I've added to my collection. And I'm glad I was as discerning as I have been, you know? Because I think I made it out with some really good gems, honestly. And hopefully not too many regrets. I'd love to know what you picked up for holiday. What have you been loving? Do you have any regret purchases even? Let us know. But thank you so much for being here. I hope you guys are doing well. Thank you so much for all the love and support on all the videos lately. I really do appreciate it. And yeah, I'm gonna leave it here. Thanks so much for watching. Bye guys.